This is NDTV. And you're watching Classics.
Hello and welcome to Walk the Talk. I am Shekhar Gupta and I stand in the middle of Warsaw, Bombay's suburban sprawl, where a lot of the aspiring models, actors from all over India, particularly small towns, first come in, find homes, paying guest accommodation, really in their struggling faces. But they come with stars in their eyes, as did my guest for today, Lakshmi Pandit. In fact, you saw her being crowned the most beautiful woman in India, Lakshmi, just the other day. And then she gave it all away, so quietly. And she's been very quiet since then, but I'm glad she's agreed to speak and break her silence now.
I'm glad to speak to you and to the audience, of course.
Lakshmi, welcome to Walk the Talk.
Thank you.
It's been a tough couple of weeks for you.
Yes, it's been quite tough, but now I've taken it in my stride and I'm going on with my life.
And your sizable stride, as I can see. But tell me exactly what happened. Just give me sort of...
Well, to start off, I can even remember the first pre-judging that happened before the show, as it happened yesterday for me. The night before that, I was pretty nervous about the pre-judging and all, and I was doing my ujjayi breath, as I'd been taught to do to calm my nerves and all.
You were doing what?
Ujjayi breathing, that's taught in Art of Living.
Right.
And that is supposed to calm our nerves and make us steady.
Are you an Art of Living follower, a follower of Sri Sri?
Not exactly a follower, but we had a short course of Art of Living in, during the training period of the seminar. And I thought I should do it to calm my nerves before prejudging. And I remember still sitting in my room on my bed doing the ujjayi breathing. And by next morning, I was quite calm and composed. And I took into the prejudging quite well. Went through all the judges pretty well. I was comfortable. And at the end of it, I was kind of confident that I've done well. And I was hoping for the best. And that I remember like yesterday. And the next day was the day of the show. Tried to remain as calm as possible. I was a little nervous though. And as you know, the next bit was the show. And the show went on like quite smooth. I was one of the top nine. I won Miss Perfect 10 and I won Miss Photogenic. And I was really very thrilled. Thank you. And after that was the question which, well, my famous chivalry answer. I've been really, really complimented.
What exactly was the question and what was the answer?
Well, the question was from one of the most renowned designer choreographers in India, that's Hemant Trivedi.
Hemant Trivedi, huh?
Yes, and he asked me, when a man opens a door for a woman or when he pulls a chair for a woman, is it because he sees it as equality? Or is it because of mere chauvinism? I thought for a second and I realized it's neither equality nor chauvinism. And that was what my answer was. I said it's chivalry. And chivalry is not dead even today. And I felt that I'm proud of all the men in this planet who have kept chivalry alive up to today. And that was what my answer was. And I got really, really complimented for that. Lots of people coming up to me saying that that was a fabulous answer.
But that's not too many men.
What? Yeah, lots of men came up to me and said that was
I said that it's not too many men who've kept chivalry alive. Because I think...
Well, quite a lot I have. The people I've met have.
But you also then became the victim of some. What happened subsequently?
Well, subsequently...
What did you feel when you get the crown?
Oh, yeah. When I got the crown, I was thrilled. I was dazed and it never sunk into me that the crown was on my head. It was just happening. And I was very happy and there was a lot of TV interviews happening. And that night, me and my friends were sitting in my room chatting up to 3 o'clock about all the happenings of the evening. We were very happy. And next morning, well, it was all an outing in Mumbai, going and meeting all the sponsors of the event and giving public appearances. There were a zillion people coming up and taking autographs, and that was really a dream come true day for me. It was very nice, lovely. And that was the next day.
And then something happened to break that dream a bit?
Yes, that was the sad bit. The same night, I got a call from Well, the whole thing started somewhere in the Provog lounge where one of the news channels had got a bit of news from somewhere. And all this broke out. And I never thought it would blow up into such a big hype. And it just happened that way. The same night, I got a call from the Times saying that there's a bit of bad news here. And just don't get taken aback the next morning if there's a little bit of publicity about it in the morning. And they thought we'll handle it in the morning. So that's how it all started.
Publicity means if there are stories or news channels.
There was this news that my landlady had spoken about.
Saying that for renting the house, you had claimed that you were married.
Yes.
And then what happened next morning?
Next morning, I had to clarify to the Times that whatever I said to the landlady was only because I needed the house at that time and I could not find a house in Bombay and my ramp career was taking off to the skies. I was becoming a very busy model and I had to find a house for myself. So, and wherever I went in Bombay looking for houses, they would not give a house to a girl who's single and especially if she's in show business. They just don't. So I had to...
Kind of things people said to you when you asked for a house on your own?
They would just say no. They did not want a girl, a single girl, who, especially because I was in the showbiz, to live in their house. They felt it was just not done. So I had to take this route of finding a house.
Did they just turn you away or...?
Yeah, they'd just say no. We don't give a house to a single girl. We need married couples.
But that's funny for a city like Bombay, which is, you know, otherwise so liberal and so...
They say it's liberal, but in this aspect, from my experience and the experience of several of my friends, it's not liberal in that aspect. So this is what happened. I was shunned away from several houses and I desperately needed a house over my head. And when I went to this place, I thought, okay, fine. If they need a married woman, fine, I'll declare that. And I guess that was a big mistake and I did that.
But you're certainly not married.
I am not married. I'm not married.
Not married, almost married.
Not at all married, not married.
Living in, although funnily that doesn't break the rule.
No, I'm not living in, I'm not married. Right. I'm single.
You definitely just signed this just to get the house.
Yes.
Is that something that a lot of people do, a lot of girls do, particularly in your business, in modeling, glamour, when they come to Bombay? Are they made to, do they have to do it?
Well, from what I know, several of my friends have done this.
Right.
And I hope they remain in their homes safely and they don't face the problem that I have faced.
Right. But is it par for the course? If you don't get a house, just claim to be married, just get a friend, a male friend, a boyfriend, whatever, and just say, you are married.
That's an easy way out, actually. I took that route because I was very busy as a model and I was traveling international every now and then, at least 2 times a month. So I had absolutely no time to go finding houses more and more. I did try quite a lot, but I couldn't go on anymore. But, so I took this route.
But you have many friends or you know of many other people who've done exactly this.
Yes.
And it's not held against them even in their personal lives.
Their
families, their boyfriends, their future husbands saying, how come you were married?
No, it wouldn't, because it was only for the purpose of a house. And many of my friends do that only for the purpose of the house.
It is accepted as such. It's a common practice.
Not a common practice, but for the sake of a roof over a girl's head.
Right.
That happens.
It's an accepted practice. So are many of those friends telling you are unlucky and this is just a...
Yes, my friends stood by me. They said, bad times do come. So just take it in your stride and go along.
Then why didn't you try to make that point more strongly and said, look, I wasn't married. This was just a, if I can use that expression, a marriage of convenience. So why hold that against me? Why did you give it up so easily?
I didn't give it up easily. It was a lot of emotional stress on me and even my family. My parents were pretty upset about the whole thing. I didn't want to hold on to the crown when there was so much of bad publicity, as I can say, about all this. And there was so much of extra hype about something that never existed. So I felt...
But did people give you a sufficient chance to explain yourself?
Yes, I did clarify myself to the Times. That's where I needed to clarify, right. And I clarified myself.
Right.
And all this was very emotionally very heavy on me, and I didn't want it. I wanted to go on with my life, so I decided I'd voluntarily give up my crown.
Right.
And what happened with your family, with your friends? Did some of them advise you not to give up? And they said,
my
what's
family
the big deal?
Stood by me. They stood by me. I did not want to. It was very emotionally strainful on me and stressful. So they said, fine, if this is your decision, then we stand by you. They stood by me just as before.
So describe to me your feelings when you, the moments when you took the decision to give it up. Just in whatever detail you remember.
Well, I don't remember much of details because it was a lot of stress on me, and I decided that I don't have to go through the stress. I'm not married, it's simple, and there was too much of hype on all that, so I decided, fine, let me voluntarily give up the crown and keep my happiness to myself.